Hello students, in this video I will discuss the poem A Photograph. So let me start with some basic idea about the poem A Photograph. The poem A Photograph is about transience of human life. Human life, man is mortal. It is about the ephemeral state of human life or transience of human life. Death and mysteries surrounding them. The poet is looking at the photograph of her mother and missing her. The photograph depicts the scene of her mother's childhood when she, along with her cousins, Betty, Dolly and uncle, had gone to the beach. And remember, dear students, at that time she was 12 years old. She means the poet's mother. We can also say from this poem that time and tide waits for none. Everything changes with the passage of time. Once the events are gone, they only remain a thing of past, and you either get pleasure or sadness after reviving them. Now, later when we recollect those memories as a nostalgic one, then it can either give us pleasure or it can be tragic. It can give sadness to us also at the same time. When we revive a memory, the memory can be a good one, pleasant one. It can be a sad one also. They just remain as a faint picture in our mind. As we saw in the poem Photograph, the poet remembers her old happy days with her mother after seeing the photograph. For her, her mother's laughter has become a thing of past, because now the poet's mother, she is no more. So just like the poet's mother missed her own childhood days, similarly for the poet, it is the laughter of her mother that she badly missed now, because her mother is no more. The poem also reflects nature's eternity as compared to mortal life of humans. Man is mortal, but nature, it is eternal. It is everlasting. Now let us move on to the summary of the poem, A Photograph. Now, structurally, the poem consists of 19 lines. Since these lines are not divided into stanzas, they are divided into meaningful segments. Here, for the purposes of this summary, in order to make the poem easier to understand and follow. Now, stanza-wise, it has not been divided. But the important thing is that it is divided into some meaningful segments that will help us to understand the poem very well. And another important information, the poem is written in the first person. Hence, it is safe to assume that the speaker of the poem is the poet herself. Yes. Now, it is very easy for her to assume that the speaker is the poet herself. Now, let us come to line number 1 to 4. Let me go through the lines first, and then I am moving on to the explanation part. That is also given here. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so. So these are the first four lines of the poem. Now in this line, the poet describes looking through a photo album, a very old photo album, the pages of which seem to be made of cardboard. The pages of the photo album, it is made up of cardboard. She is looking at one particular picture. It is a picture of three girls. That is the poet's mother, along with her two cousins, Betty and Dolly. The tallest and oldest one in the middle, and two younger and shorter ones at each side of her. And remember, dear students, I already told you that the poet's mother was the eldest one. She was 12 years old. The girl in the middle is the poet's mother, and the poet speculates that her mother must have been around 12 years old when the picture was taken, and she was the big girl, and she was holding the hands of the other two girls' cousins. It shows love and also a sense of security. Each of the cousin is holding on to one of the other girls' hands for support. The picture has been taken on a day that the three girls had gone paddling at the beach. Or rather to say, it is a picture, or the picture reflects once upon a time, her mother, when she was very young, a little girl of 12 years or so, went for a sea holiday, and one of the uncle had clicked the picture. Now let us move on to line number 5-9. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. A sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Now, terribly transient is an alliteration, that is the figure of speech. We'll come to the discussion regarding the figure of speech later also. So let me explain now the lines of the poem. In these lines, the poet further describes the conditions in which the photograph of her mother and her mother's cousins was taken. The poet says that her mother's uncle had been the one to take the photograph. It is also written in the poem also in the sixth line. Uncle with the camera, that means one of their close relative uncle, he clicked the picture. He had asked the three girls to pose for him, and so they had. They had left their wet hair open, and their hair was obscuring part of their faces. Now, the sea breeze was blowing, and it has almost obstructed or restricted part of their faces. But it was a very beautiful picture that was been clicked by the uncle. It also suggestive of the wet hair of the girls, because that thing is also noticeable in the picture. Though the film of hair covering their mouths, one could see that they were smiling into the camera. But it is very clear from the way the picture has been projected that they were looking at the camera. And not only they are looking at the camera, but they were smiling by looking at the camera. However, one face in the picture draws the poet's attention to a greater degree than the other two faces. And that face is the face of the poet's mother. It is her mother's face. I already told you right now that part that she is concentrating on. And she comments that the face was a sweet one. The poet also says that the photograph was taken long before her own birth. Since then, her mother's face had of course changed since the time the photograph had been taken. Now, this is the law of mortality. Now, what we were 10 years ago, every one of us, what we were 10 years ago, frankly speaking, now there is a lot of change in us. Both physically and mentally, both biologically and rationally, there is a lot of change in us. Now, with the passage of time, change occurs. It is something we call, it's a biological change, it's a physical change, that is almost certain, it is unanimous, it is universal. And it is one of the law of nature also. Similar change can be seen now in case of the poet's mother also. The poet also says that the photograph was taken long before her own birth. Since then, her mother's face had of course changed since the time the photograph had been taken. In contrast to this, the sea which lay along the beach where the photograph was taken had changed to a lesser degree. World of nature also underwent a change, practically speaking, but not to that great extent at which it happens in the case of mortal human beings. That very sea had been washing the feet of the poet's mother and her two younger cousins the day the photograph had been taken. The poet calls those feet terribly transient, since all the girls in that photograph had stopped being so young and had grown up since then. Their childhood hasn't lasted very long. it passed away very quickly. And with the passage of time, not only they became big girls, but they became housewives and mothers also. As in the case of the poet's mother, it can be felt, because she later, after 1.5 decade or 2 decades later, when she saw the picture, she went on smiling and recollecting that nostalgic moment that she spent in that beach holiday. Now I am moving on to line number 10 to 13. Some 20, 30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. See Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach, the sea holiday. In these lines, the poet stops looking at the photograph and recalls what her mother used to say about the photograph. The poet isn't sure whether it was 20 years after the photograph was taken or 30 years after it. She was not sure about it. But she remembers her mother telling her to look at how the cousins, called Betty and Dolly, looked at that young age. The poet's mother also asked her to look at how their parents had dressed them up for a visit to the beach. Perhaps the plan to take the photograph had been there all along. That is the reason the little girls were wearing the swimming costumes. Now, after almost 20, 30 years later, the poet's mother is smiling, laughing heartily by looking at the photograph, because it brought back in her mind some pleasant old memories. Now I am moving on to line number 14-15. Was her past, mine is a laughter, both wry with the labored ease of loss. Now, labored ease of loss, this is an oxymoron. Now, figure of speech, I will discuss regarding that later. Now, let us come to the explanation. In these lines, the poet says that her mother used to consider the photograph as an inroad to the past that she had left behind. Now, when she saw that photograph, she remembered many things that already happened in the past. On the other hand, the poet herself considered the memory of her mother laughing as a relic of the past that she missed every day. Relic is something related to some old thing. In both the cases, the memories of the past made the two women contemplating them feel disappointed as they tried hard to come to terms with what they had lost. Now, for her mother, it was her childhood that she had lost forever. And for the poet herself, it was the smile of her mother, and most importantly, her mother, because her mother had died. And she died almost 12 years. The age of the big girl in that photograph. That means in the photograph, the age of the mother was 12 years. And she died almost 12 years had passed. So that 12 is very important. Now I am moving on to line number 16 to 19. Now she has been dead nearly as many years as the girl lived, and of this circumstance there is nothing to say at all. It silence silences. That is also a alliteration. It is also a personification, because silence has been personified. In these lines, the poet says that her mother had been dead for the past 12 years. That is the same number of years that was the age of her mother in the photograph that she had been looking at. Already I have told that that her mother died almost 12 years past. The same age the daughter is in that photograph. The big girl, that is the poet's mother. The poet is able to think of her mother's death, but she has no words with which to explain how that death has affected her, because now it is silence and silence silences. The fact that the death has silenced her mother has also left her speechless and created a sort of emotional voidness in her life. Now she is totally speechless, and now her life is a tragic one, because not only she missed the laughter or the smile of her mother, but she missed her mother also. Dear students, I explained it. Now you all listen to it, and any doubts, later you can clarify. Thank you, students.